interesting one, and that may have been the end of my academic journey, but thereafter I started practicing. So as a practitioner, I think I can stand before you and say to you what I have learned and put that before you for your contemplation and decide whether, as you journey, you will be enriched from my lessons. So I'm going to start talking to you about what is my Mbokodo. Now, Mbokodo comes from Watent Abafazi Watent Mbokodo. So if you strike a woman, you touch her. Now, in 1956, that's why we have Women's Day, we had over 50,000 women of all races that combined together to stand against the pass rules. So women were always political. We were always activists. So Watent Abafazi Watent Mbokodo, it was the heart of that resistance. Now, because I've walked this road as an advocate for 18 years, I'm going to tell you how I personalize my Mbokodo. And I am going to tell you and invite you in 10 or 20 years' time, you come and tell me what your Mbokodo is. Because what shaped me won't shape you. Everyone's path is different. So Mbokodo is a rock in English. So I'm going to tell you what my rock is. And to make it easy, I said, R is for respect, O is for opportunity costs, C is for consultation, and K is for knowledge. Now, I'm not one to impose my views upon you. So this is my path. You will have your own Mbokodo. You will one day, 10 years' time, 12 years' time, think about what shaped you, why you can stand tall against any striking, and why if someone strikes you, it will be just a touch. Watent Abafazi Watent Mbokodo. Treated well, you are respected. So if somebody slaps you you around and you think I'm there, I love them, and reassess that situation. So, in any event, R is for respect, and that's what I'm looking for. I will tell you about my other cardinal core, which is opportunity cost. Now, in my BCom degree, I majored in economics. Economics is not like accountants. Accountants will teach you about profit and loss. They teach you about turnover, less the cost, this is your profit, or this is your loss. So it is something that's tangible, it's rand and cents, or dollars. Opportunity cost is something that you don't see in that balance sheet. But opportunity cost is the reason that you're here today. So you could have sat and said, well, I could be at home, I could be sleeping in late, I could be at my feet up, I could be doing whatever else. But there was a cost for you not to be at this tour with Sinako today. So, for me too. I mean, this. But I thought, what would I not gain by being here versus sitting and loafing at home? It's good to rest. There are always times where we need to rest because resting is how we internalize learning and evolve and you move forward strong. So even if you're training as a swimmer, you need rest days. So resting is not something that is bad, it's good. But you can't, if you're resting 5 days out of seven, then that's like questionable. So what I'm sharing with you is for me, throughout my journey when I needed to make decisions, I would ask what is the opportunity cost? What is the cost of foregoing my next best option? So you weigh up all the scenarios and you say, okay, there's a cost, but if I don't go there, what is the cost? So what is the cost of not coming here today? It could be that you have not walked into that library. You were not in the press area. You were not absorbing this information. So that is the cost of deciding not to be here. So it is an opportunity cost. So I will say to you when you are, or what I did, and I'll share with you and encourage you is when you need to make decisions, factor in the opportunity cost of not walking that path. Because there's always that cost involved. For C, I will tell you is consultation. I have achieved what I have because I think the humility that Sinako has is part of my core. I consult. So I would initially, I thought learner technical skill was all important. So I would have consulted with the person that I thought had the skill. But today I will say to you, no. If I'm unsure, even if I just want clarity to debate an idea, I consult with a good, kind person who has the necessary technical skill. So I'm not only going to consult with somebody that I think is brilliant, but it must be somebody that's brilliant, that is a good, has a good heart. So I consult. So if I decide that I want to maybe move to Port Elizabeth and start a practice there, where my roots are, perhaps I think very highly of a certain judge and a certain advocate. Maybe I would consult with him. What do you think? Am I being a bit hasty? What are your views? I can tell you personally, one of my greatest consultants is my mother. So I consult, and my mom is a foundation phase teacher. She's retired, and she gives the greatest of wisdom. So that is someone that I consulted with. Lot of my issues, because sometimes it's good to have someone you trust, you throw the idea out, you talk, and you rest. So respect, opportunity cost, consultation, and then the last one I want to say, who in this room believes knowledge is power? Put up your hand. Okay, so if you want here, I want to say to you, I want to challenge you, and I want to tell you, I don't think knowledge is power. Knowledge, all those books in the library that we saw, it is useless. So knowledge must be transformed into action to impact society. When you impact society with the knowledge that you have, that is power. that is transforming society. So when you walk into a library, you must know that I am reading that book in order to internalize that knowledge. For what purpose? I would submit to you that the purpose would be to impact society, because the entire constitution is a transformative one.
Yes.
So if you are not using that knowledge in order to impact society, to make the world a better place, then where's your power? So I challenge you, and I say knowledge is not power. You need to use it. So if you have all the doctorates and academic knowledge, for me, the person that is changing the life and making somebody else smile or have a better day, that is a better impact than sitting there and hoarding knowledge. So what you do learn, share. And that is the Sinako Weekend Movement, and that's the 12. So Sinako has learned so much by having worked with the Constitutional Court judges, and she's not keeping that to herself. She's not being selfish about it. She created this platform to address all of us. And then she didn't leave me out of the equation. She invited me also. So she's acting in a synergetic fashion. 1 + 1 equals 5. And that is Ubuntu. I am because you are. There is more that I can address you on, but I think we will take that further at the later point because of time constraints. Thank you so much.